Hi, everybody. Here we are at Lounge Academy. It's a Friday night. It's always a Friday night at Lounge Academy. It's always Friday night here. You ever notice that? And we see that GT is the first guy popping up here, which is good because he's our and Len, my cigar meister. How are you, sir? Nice to see you. Len, check this out, Len. I was just thinking about you this week. In fact, I was looking at you this week. You see this? This is a, Len, this is a movie camera from, well, we were using it in the year 2001, a Lounge Odyssey. And you're on that. I got the old reels of tape, and I started going through them, and I bought an interface to get it on the computer so I could store them on YouTube. And you're over at EB Green's partying it up with all of us back when you had your cigar store there. It was great stuff. So I'm looking forward to Len seeing that in all his cigar dealer glory and lounge glory. We're just getting rolling here. Sorry, I hope we didn't keep you in anticipation too long. You know, we usually try to kick it around around 7-ish every Friday here at WBIG.TV in the heart of Buffalo's downtown core lounge district. And we've got some nice camera angles for you tonight. Oops, the little control panels getting warmed up here. Here we go. Here's the corner shot. And you can see there's a few lounge cadets. They're over there at the VIP table having some munchies. They'll be joining us at the piano where you'll see them here on my shoulder shot cam. And here you can see the back of their heads a little more clearly. That's Handsome Dan that's with his back to you. You know a lot of these lounge cadets. You'll be excited to see Alan back on the set of Lounge Academy. He's been off for weeks and weeks. He's over 90 years old, and he was having some health issues. He had an operation, and now he's bouncing back. And we were out whining and dining last night with Alan, and he's back on the set, and that's his, you could tell he shares beard DNA with the gentleman on his left. That's his son, Scott. He's in from California looking after him and enjoying his time in Buffalo. And to Handsome Dan's right, standing in the blue blazer, of course, with the bow tie, is WBIG-TV's president, Ryan Lysars. You can see he's pretty engrossed in the hors d'oeuvres. And to his right is one of the home favorites of Lounge Academy, is jazz singer McNeil. And she's having a conversation with Barry, who's going to be up here playing the piano. Barry's a surgeon, and he uses surgical precision when he's playing the piano, as you know. Lizzie's tuned in here. Great to have you in the lounge with us, Lizzie, Karen Lizzie. I'll tell everybody. Karen Lizzie says hi to everybody. She's tuned in from her remote lounge base in Florida. There, I just said hi to everybody. And Christine's out there. It's always great to hang with Christine. What are they eating? Well, that's a good question, Christine. They're having steaming hot loaf, which is something I prepare for the cast and crew. It's 100% whole wheat bread. Oh, and look, I just turned around. I see Susan Peters and Mary are hanging out. Mary, come on out of that dead zone there. Hang on, I'm gonna get Mary over here. January 20th, and I'll send it over to you.
everybody.
What's going to happen now?
Well, this way they can see us.
Oh, yeah, we're back. We're in the blind spot.
Yeah, it's my first podcast like this today.
Yes, one story of the work day. I went there for soup and
coffee.
Yeah. Yeah, I really like
it. 2 hours a week? Our hours. Tuesday, 1:30 to 1:00.
Very exclusive. Very exclusive. You're going to have them lined up around the neighborhood.
We are reminded of my grandmother. I like that. The mother lives in our thing.
Oh, wow. Okay.
They take care of their rat product
in the summer.
Oh, well, I'm sure they've debated it to some
find out what their secret is.
And the neighbors in the barber shop.
Oh, wow.
Okay, forgive me for the absence here. Actually, just my voice was absent. I was closer to the camera. And right now I'm going to... Making our way back to these... We had a big bottle of Louis the 13th, Paul, and I chugged it just before I went on. It's going to hit me any moment now. I always down a bottle of that with a funnel before we start Lounge Academy. I'm monkeying around with equipment here. Now, this is the hair cam you're looking at. And you can see what I'm doing here. A lot of people are fascinated by the technology that makes Lounge Academy go. And that's what I'm monkeying with right now. I can hear myself. That's good. This is my. I bought some headphones. I forgot to pick them up today at the UPS store. They came in from Amazon. I got them just for you guys because I wanted to be able to just put them on for like a few seconds several times throughout the show just to check the audio quality. Well, that'd be great, Paul. We'll need we'll have to bust out some good cigars for that stuff, that's for sure.
Alan has joined the living.
Here, let me just do this.
Now we're going to get back to our split screen. And I think this is probably the best angle for you, because we have to check my hair.
Yeah, I know.
There it is. See,
isn't it great modern medicine?
You can see how straight the part is. So it's straight enough where we can start the show. We got some great, great guests in the in studio tonight. A lot of great musical guests, singers, actors, surgeons. We're gonna have a whole mixed bag. It's like a variety show. Salesmen. All artists, for sure. Happy New Year, Alex Leonard. I was enjoying a lot of your work over the holiday. You guys were providing a lot of WBIG.TV bandwidth. All right, Christine. Yeah, Marty's going to bring the cream ale. I remember Marty brought Krupnik one time, and I've been a Krupnik addict ever since, and that was about 15 years ago. Now I always have to have it in stock at home, and me and the cats sit around and have a Krupnik on a cold night. If you're new to Lounge Academy and you're just tuning in, this is what we do every Friday nights from about 7 o'clock till we quit. We which is not too late, 10:30, 11, if that late. Sometimes it goes that late. And it's loose because we never know what the producers of the show have in store for us. It's all unscripted, and we don't get a heads up. So usually we're sitting here not knowing what's going to happen. But we got a little later start tonight, so some of the guests came out of the green room already by the time we kicked on the cameras. It gets very quiet in here when they're feeding. David Vernon, ladies and gentlemen. How about a big round of applause for David Vernon and Alex Leonard? Tuning in from the Big Apple. And Jeff Feinberg, fine Buffalo musician, quite an inspiration to all of us. Well, thanks, Jeff. I do that to distract people. That's always the takeaway. And Maxine Lamar. Maxine Lamar, ladies and gentlemen. Maxine is, she's big time. She hangs out with David Vernon. I think that's how I know Maxine. I think we met because our mutual friend, David Vernon, she came upon us here because we celebrate the Great American Songbook every Friday night. Here on WBIG.TV, we've been, 2019 will be our second calendar year that includes live streaming each week. We just finally got into that around last summer. Before that, we've been doing this for years. It was all done in post-production. Now it's live. At Lounge Academy, Mary's gonna join me. She's pulling up a chair at the piano. Everyone else is eating. How you doing, Mary Kunz Goldman? It is a nice night. It's a warm night in Buffalo Town.
Yeah, not too bad.
For those expats tuning in from their warm cities. It's pretty warm right here. Right, Lizzie? There's some members of the public outside, but we have to just kind of like tell them they're screwed because the door is locked.
Yeah, we have people looking at the building. They see us enjoying our food. We're sitting here on the piano. They see us sitting here
smiling. Whole tone run? Yeah, I can do a whole tone run. Not a run, I can do a whole tone something. Let's see. That goes good with like one of these chords.
The same.
Well, it's not a whole tone. I feel like I'm dreaming when I hear a whole tone scale. I want everybody to close their eyes. Think of the craziest dream you've ever had.
That was just last night.
And how real it was when you were having it. And you woke up and you realized just how entirely unlikely that dream was. I had the craziest dream last night. Yes, I did. Handsome Dan, I never dreamt it could be. But there she was. See that, ladies and gentlemen? That's because he had a job, unlike me. I saw her lips next to mine, so I kissed them. Oh, I gotta get you guys the right screen here, I'm sorry. You had to look at me. When I'm away, such a break never happens. How long can a guy go on dreaming? How long, Handsome Dan? If there's a chance that you care, then please, please say you do, my baby. Say it and make my crazy dreams come true. It was so real. Then I woke up. There she was. Between me and the cat. Find out if there's a chance that you care, then please, please say you do, my baby. Say it and make my crazy dreams come true. Say it and make my crazy dreams all true. With Susan Peters. Doesn't Susan look great with that leopard hat on? And she is the essence of lounge. Fantastic. What a singer, too, and you're going to find out later if you don't already know that one. Sit and make my crazy dreams true. We have a record breaking 11 people watching. I didn't know there were 11 people. I didn't know I knew 11 people. You know what I think it is? Everybody's just like sitting home lounging after that holiday week, right? Is it kind of nice to know all those pleasant memories are behind us? Now you don't have to talk to your relatives till it's your birthday, or they won't get you anything. So many great songs to choose from tonight. Well, try, Rich, you're having a little problem there. I'm monitoring on my tablet here, and the picture's coming in, so I would say try rebooting your green screen, see what happens. I also do tech support here. I wear a lot of hats, not just donut hats. So what do you think, Mary?
She will the next time. I did it in my area.
Well, they don't need me to break the ice here. They're already having a nice little intimate conversation. That's Handsome Dan and Mary. Dan's showing her his holiday photos on his camera. Or some kind of photos. I think they're pictures of his operation. Grey's Anatomy.
He's showing me a picture of a 93-year-old Austrian.
A 93-year-old Austrian woman.
Yeah, she looks great. She looks like
wow. That's some of those dating sites are amazing, aren't they?
Oh, wow. Oh,
must be J-Date. They'd have a 93-year-old Austrian woman.
Yeah, look, she was only 93. I'll show it to Howard. Whoa. Yeah, can you believe this woman's 93? Howard, look at her. Howard.
Blame it in the bossa nova.
93? She's like 93.
I used to know that song, Blame It.
No, because
it's in C, isn't it? Alex? Is that one usually, isn't it written in C? If I, ba-ba-da-da, both day and night and day, blame it on my youth, Blame it on the youths.
Blame it on the youth.
Man, I can't believe I haven't played that one in so long. Let's see if it's in here. We're taking no practicing.
Song of over male domination.
We're taking requests from people that know their stuff.
Oh yeah, that was always a number of yours, Dad.
Tell me the chords of that one.
It's an A minor.
I'll remember it.
A minor to E7.
I think it's it's. Well, I don't want to go tearing through the books to find it. Oscar Levant. Did he do that one? Oscar Levant. He pronounced it Levant. Not the fancy way, Levant. Yeah. My bossa nova version of it.
I thought it was in that book. It's not in that book.
Here's another one Oscar Levant liked.
This is the girl I taught the class.
Oh.
My next court is
in
my
room. Oh,
okay.
McNeil. She shot around when I mentioned Oscar Levant. She's got a thing. Most people, I've got a thing for Oscar Levant too.
I thought it was in this book, Howard.
I like the way he crashed at Gershwin's house. Blame it on vermouth. Mary, find Blame It On My Youth.
I thought it was in here. It's not in this book.
Well, see if you, well,
I can picture it in this
yeah,
book.
See if it's in there. I'm going to do this one. Here's a good song that nobody does. This heart of mine was doing very well. The world was fine as far as I could tell. Suddenly I met you and I dreamed of gay amour. Dawn I woke up singing sentimental overture. This heart of mine is dancing gaily now. I taste the wine of real romancing now. This crazy world has taken on a wonderful design. As long as life endures, it's yours, this heart of mine. With my mic stand. Who's here, ladies and gentlemen? We're complete again. This heart of mine is dancing gaily now. I taste the wine of real romancing now. This crazy world is taking on. John Curry.
John.
Oh, I didn't see him.
He always reminds me of Garth.
He looks great.
The other guy, the other one.
We don't know.
Oh, okay. That's what I thought. No.
This Heart of Mine. It's a great song. John Curry, ladies and gentlemen. You look great, too. You must be sick. You look great. Things falling.
I know.
I'm better now.
Well, this is getting off to a good start here at Lounge Academy. A lot of big, really surprised guests. People that have been missing for a while.
I like your drawing.
Thank you. I'm having a great time with it.
Oh, yeah. Krupnik and Lionel Trains. That's a good cocktail right there, Marty. Welcome to Lounge Academy. We're live streaming here. In case people don't know, you're on TV. We're live streaming. John knows that. He watches Lounge Academy.
He's a lounge cadet.
He's a lounge cadet in good standing.
I was trying to get it.
All right, we'll let you in, Paul, when you get here. Ryan, watch the door for Paul Cambria. He said he's on his way over.
Who is?
Paul Cambria.
He's on his way over?
That's what he said.
Well, he's not going to see my sketch yet.
He said we. He said we're on our way.
Oh, wow.
He and Louis are on the way.
Who's
Louis? Louis the 13th.
Oh. He's my patron.
Somebody loves me, I wonder who, she can be. I'm surrounded by artists. Somebody loves me. I painted myself into a corner once. More than once. Who she can be worries me. For every girl that passes me, I shout out, maybe you were meant to be my loving baby. Somebody loves me, I wonder who. Maybe it's you. over there. You never know who it could be. Another good Gershwin tune. Speaking of, Bob Davis is out there in the lounge universe.
I want to make a few remarks about the painting that I'm going to unveil.
We're having an unveiling.
Let me say that this is not...
Speak up, don't be shy. The shy artist.
It's a hell of a
Ladies and gentlemen, Barry's making a speech here. You want to set down your hors d'oeuvres?
Okay.
This goes for you at home, too.
I don't want a grandstand or anything like that. But, I was very upset about the upcoming convention center and tearing down of the 153 and other things that have been suggested. So I was inspired to do this painting, and it's not architecturally, chronologically, artistically, in some other way incorrect, or correct, it's not correct. But I called it the fantasy number 153.
And, Fantasy 153.
I will show it to you.
Oh, this is a real surprise to me. Let me try to see it again.
Let's see it.
Let me adjust.
So I was thinking that what was this building like in the 1800s and in the 19th century, and what was going on there? And what's going on here now? So
that's what I'd like to know.
I thought if I could create a scene that was sort of contemporary, but back in the 1800s. So
I'm excited to see this. An original painting, it looks like, behind some cardboard. You guys could see it across the room on the fireplace. Brick over there. Barry is now removing it from that expensive case that he carries it in.
Oh, look at this. Oh my goodness. Isn't that beautiful?
Wow, that's amazing. Wow. Wow, that's terrific, Barry.
And the lantern?
Can you guys see that at home?
I've done away with the Steinbrenner wall. With the bricked up window.
Yeah, it looks good that way.
Yeah. Oh, it is a Christmas car.
What else is it? And the neighbors, I thought maybe.
I recognize the neighbor's house.
Some nice neighbors down there, but there were higher class neighbors down the street. And so I moved some of their houses. down, and we did away with Huron Street, but you know what the heck.
We didn't need it.
So I kind of stuck
beautiful.
In the.
The man lighting the lamp. Yeah. The lamp.
Well, that's terrific. We're going to try to get a camera in.
It's so different to
Paul loves it.
There's a kind of here you go.
I don't know what's going on.
As soon as the crowds.
Just the late arrivals are coming in.
I love how he's got this gentleman lighting the lamp.
He's got the Macintosh on.
I don't know what's going on in the rooms upstairs.
We might not want to know.
We don't want to know.
What happens there stays there.
That was Hiram Hotchkiss was up there with the maid.
And people going into the house, and you can see people inside. There's us. There's Susan.
We'll give you guys at home a little closer look at this soon as we can get through the crowd there with camera.
Ainsley Wilcox Mansion down because I wanted some high class neighbors here. And the,
nice. They all want to be down here.
Renaissance, 20th century club.
Oh, the 20th Century Club is our neighbor now.
Yes.
Oh.
They always wanted to be downtown.
Oh, wow. Scott, that's amazing.
Well, thank you, Barry. That,
did you see Mary?
Yeah, that's fantastic.
Reminds me of Mary Poppins.
It does, Cherry Tree Lane.
Yeah,
I always love what you do with your
lights.
You know?
See the new one.
I'd like to. Yeah.
I've always admired that, and this has a lot of that characteristic in it.
It was a fun project.
Barry, it's beautiful. There's so many things about it that are just so sweet. You've got the
you know what I'm going to do, ladies and gentlemen?
So
I'm going to take a picture of it with my camera and try to get a picture of this original painting of the old house downtown as a comment on this.
It makes you see the place differently.
Yes. So
you got us in the windows.
What I hope to do is, this is an architecturally interesting building, and it should be preserved.
Wow. I didn't know you were a painter.
Oh, Barry's amazing. Barry did the industrial painting.
All right, I just took a photograph for the benefit of the home audience, so they can see this original painting that was just unveiled here, and it's of the old house downtown as it may have looked back in the 1800s. So I'm going to see if I can get this up as a comment on this live stream post.
That's what I like.
So bear with me as I sit here and do this technical stuff.
I think it looks great. That's what I like about it. I think it's a beautiful sky.
This should only take a second to do this. Then we'll get back to the entertainment. Here we go. Here's the live stream on my camera.
Really love it. I love the lamps all the way down.
And I'm going to post. See if I can post a photograph. Can I post a photograph?
It's
not letting me post a photograph. All right, you know what I'm going to do, ladies and gentlemen?
I know, it's time for the artist to lift his brush at a certain point. I think it's beautiful.
I'm going to post it as a separate post. It sounds redundant, but that's what I'm going to do. So it won't be part of this live stream, but you'll see it as a new post on my Facebook wall going up momentarily. And you can see this original work of art that was just unveiled here at Lounge Academy. It was... done by Dr. George Barry Moore. And it was inspired by the threat to the old house downtown of eminent domain, which we are now under the cloud of because of ambitions of the convention center. Here we go. It's up there. So if you guys... look at my next post right after this live stream on my Howard Goldman Facebook page. You could see this. You could get a look at this. It's spectacular. Let me know when you get a look at that. I may be wrong, but I think you're wonderful.
Yes, you're right. You don't get that darkness.
I may be wrong, but I think you're swell. I like Barry's style, say. I think that painting's marvelous. I'm always wrong, so how can I tell? All of my shirts are unsightly. All of my ties are a crime. If daring you, I've picked rightly. It's the very first time you came along, say, I think you're wonderful. I think you're grand, but I may be wrong. Life is to me just a bore. Tell that to the boring company. Faces are all open spaces. Might be John Barrymore. I think you're grand, but I may be wrong. A little Henry Sullivan and Harry Raskin from 1929. It's called I May Be Wrong.
What's your hour?
It's nice to see you, Susan.
Thank you, Jerry.
You look like you had a great holiday.
It's always a fabulous thing when they're over.
Isn't
holidays.
It nice?
It is. Very
I mean, they're fun while they last, and then
you know, yeah, get back in the cocoon and get on with the good work.
Isn't it nice to come here to Lounge Academy and where none of your relatives are?
That's right. They're not allowed. Except for Handsome Dan. We'll let him.
Yeah.
Yes, there was a whole.
Well, he's everybody's relative.
Yeah,
right?
That's right.
Susan, what are you going to sing for us tonight?
She's got some charts. She's going to show us her stock charts.
They are stock charts. Mari doesn't have her charts, but she's going to sing something anyway.
What an all-star cast we have tonight. How are you, sir? It's nice to see you here. Susan's wearing her safe cracking gloves tonight. I like that. There's no fingers on them. She's here to looking for our safe. She's looking. No wonder she was looking behind the picture that Barry painted. Thought there was a safe back there. I guess she's not bringing charts up here. Okay. Are the stars? Are the stars out tonight? I don't know if it's cloudy or bright, but I only have eyes for you. The moon may be high, but I can't see a thing in the sky. On a corner, garden or on a crowded afternoon, you are here, so am I. John Curry and lots of people go by, but they all disappear. Another Harry Warren one, Maxine. Maxine, are we in a garden? Or on a crowded door avenue? You are here, so am I. Maxine, millions of people go by, disappear from view. That number always called. I only have eyes for you. Thank you, everybody. We've got a record number of, we've got a record number in the audience. McNeil, must be because you're on the show tonight. There's six people watching.
Incredible, still standing.
Yeah, yeah, wonderful painting, Mary.
It's such a beautiful painting.
Yeah, just, I was just blown over when you pulled
it. Just the mood of it. I love the just the brooding winter nature of it. It just, and then the warmth of the house contrasting with the chilliness of the sky and the snow. And it's such a buffalo sky. It's
brooding sky.
And I love the people going into, and he's got the L.A. for Lounge Academy.
I think that's like Nick and Kathy walking in.
Oh, I think it is.
In the painting.
Yes, in the painting, Nick and Kathy. It's like Nick and Kathy. And Barry said he intended himself to be the lamplighter.
Some guy vandal. He's probably painting it. The spray can. Did you guys go in at home audience look at the original artwork that was unveiled here tonight? It's in the very next post on my Facebook profile.
That's beautiful. Yeah,
well, the idea is that
you're lighting it up. You're showing it to us.
I want to call attention to the knocking down.
Oh, yes. Okay, you don't want it knocked down. Yeah. Yeah, you're right.
Okay.
I forgot all about that. Yeah, it's a statement, a powerful statement against demolition.
Why shouldn't I? I'm Melinda Miller. Take a chance when romance passes by. Thank you, Alan. Thanks for making tonight extra special. Thank you, Scott. Scott's Alan's handler. Show business, we have handlers. You can see Alan working his way around the room, glad handing everybody, and that's how we do things here. Everyone wants him. Great having Alan back on the scene, I can tell you that. The home audience, that's why we got a record number of viewers. There's four right now. I think one of them is Melinda Miller, right? Melinda, are you out there? I think she's sitting at a table with, a virtual table with Maxine Lamar.
Virtual table.
Say hi to Maxine Lamar, Mary. She's out there.
Maxine Lamar. Thank you for joining us.
She's a jazz.
I know.
Huge.
I'm honored to have her.
Yeah. Mary knows.
You're celebrating that painting.
Yeah, it's
painting. Oh, he stands it on that pile of books.
Yeah, that's why we do things at the Goldman Museum of Modern Art. Thank you, Scott.
Thanks, Howard.
Scott's now hugging everybody on the way out. Uh-oh, now he's going to hug me. Thanks,
Happy
Scott.
New Year, Howard. Thank you.
Thank you. Happy New Year. Thanks for bringing Alan with you.
My pleasure.
Sat down, he's waiting for Scott to finish shaking hands. You can tell they've got they share the same beard DNA. Right? It's like a mini me beard. Right? It's beautiful. Yeah, we like that, Alan. We discussed it. We like it. We're going to get you a couple of stone tablets to hold, and we're going to take your picture.
Make sure you work out.
Here we are, the 15 commandments. Oops, the 10 commandments. Sellers is playing all the angles. If it takes forever, I will wait for you. 4,000 summers, I will wait for you. Till you're back beside me. Till I'm holding you.
I love that the painting is visible from the piano.
I know, I got a perfect view of it.
I hope Nick and Kathy are coming so she can see it.
Yeah.
It's like, I think Einstein said if you had a strong enough telescope, you'd see.
Let's see, where was I?
He's got it.
Why should I? Take a chance when romance passes by. Why shouldn't I know of love? Why wait around? Each age has a sage who has found that upon this earth love is all.
must be fun. Lots of fun. To be sure, when day is done, that the hour is coming when you'll be kissing then. You'll be kissed again. All debutantes.
They say it's good.
They say it's good.
It's good.
And every star out and far, how it would seem to give it a try. So why shouldn't Richard Craney see a Richard Curry, Craney? Curry, I was just talking to John Curry. Richard Craney is not only a lounge cadet in good standing, but he's a donut cadet in good standing. He's all the way out in Colorado. He sent us some great pictures of his donuts on the dashboard of his car and his hat on, his donut hat, official hat of the Department of Coffee and Donuts. And his mug.
Oh, that's wonderful.
The whole shooting match. Oh, California. I'm sorry. Who's in Colorado? I sent some to Colorado. Yeah, I'll find that one, Rich. Explosion when two tingles intermingle. Who cares to define what chemistry this is? Who cares with your lips on mine? What ignorant bliss is? How hard you kiss me and the world around us shatters. How little it matters. How little we know. This is, who cares with your lips on mine, what ignorant bliss is, how long you kiss me, and the world around us shatters, how little it matters, how little we know, how little we know, how little we know. Handsome Dan. Yeah, Rocky Mountain. Why'd you say CA?
You're in Colorado, Richard, right? You wrote CA, like California. You're in scenic Colorado. I knew that. You were trying to test the security of my knowledge. I know my donut cadets. Don't try to fool me. Once I laughed when I heard you say that I'd be playing solitaire, uneasy in my easy chair. Dan's in an easy chair. It never entered Dan's mind. Once you told me I was mistaken, that I'd awaken with the sun and order orange juice for one. It never entered my mind. You have what I lack myself. Once you warned me that if you scorned me, I'd sing a maiden's prayer again and wish that you were there again to get into my head. Never entered my mind.
Rogers
and Harris. Thank you, McNeil. That was McNeil leading off that round of applause over at the VIP table, and we're joined by Gaia out in the audience. Vicky, how are you? I get to call her Gaia. That's her stage name. I see a heart coming up. That might have been from Gaia. Listening for noises at the door in case Paul or somebody shows up. They're probably playing the timing the parking game.
That hasn't started though, has it?
No, but people aren't sure about it. Actually, it's unclear. But they didn't change the signs yet. So, according to arcane bits of the law, that. I like the somber stuff too, Gaia. This one isn't too somber, but we'll get to some breakup songs after this one. If I don't see her each day, I miss her. I'm hearing things. Or is that might be John Curry tapping on the table. Here we go. Take three. I thought I heard the door. If I don't see her each day, I miss her. Gee, what a thrill. Each time I see that kisser, I've got a case. And I got it for, got my case from Nancy. Nancy with the laughing face. She takes the winter. She makes it summer. Summer could take some lessons from her. Picture a tomboy in lace. That's Nancy with a laughing face. You'll hear bells ringing. Well, she'll give you the very same glow. When she speaks, you would think, you'd think it was singing. Just hear her say, hello. I swear to goodness, you can't resist her. Here's the best line right here. Sorry for you. She has no sister. No one could ever replace. That's Nancy with a laughing face. That's Jimmy Van Heusen's song, and the lyrics were written by the lyrics were by Phil Silvers. He was a 1950s into the 60s television star.
Oh, when he wrote the lyrics, there.
Yeah, he was an ex-vaudeville guy.
That's sweet.
And he had all vaudeville guys on his sitcom. They were playing on like guys at the war in World War II and stuff. We got something special coming up here, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, I have a sheaf. I don't have them in a notebook, but so I'm going to just page through and see what you want to do, because I've got them also.
I've got this one. I think it's in the same key. We're working out some charts here. You're getting to see how the sausage is made in show business.
Uh-oh. Watch out for the casing.
Yeah. Yeah, chew it. It could be tough. Same key, okay? It's a great song. I didn't know you do this song.
I don't, so this is the rehearsal portion of our program.
Oh, hey, let me turn your mic up.
Oh, right here, Susan Peter. Yeah, I put that on. I'm not sure. Let me turn it on.
She knows how to work the equipment. Ladies and gentlemen, you're in for a big treat. Susan Peters stepping up on the bandstand.
Maybe we should do something we know first.
It never seems to help me.
What's it all about? Is it
just for the moment we live in. What's it all about? When you sort it out, I'll feel our result to take more than we give. Oh, are we meant to be kind? If only it was our kind,
try singing it together. Susan, can we try that one together? Just for, since we're, yeah, we'll just see what. I don't know exactly how good it is for that, but we'll find out.
You want to start? Or do you sing together?
Either way. What's it all about? Alfie, is it just for the moment we live? What's it all about when we started out, Alfie? Are we meant to take more than we give? Or are we meant to be kind?
If only fools are kind, Alfie, then I guess it is wise to be cruel. And if life belongs only to the strong, Alfie, what will you land on an old golden rule? As sure as I believe, there's a heaven above, Alfie.
Without true love, we just exist. Alfie.
philosophy until you find the love you've missed. You're nothing healthy. When you walk, let your heart lead the way, and you'll find love any day. Susan Peters. Here's Paula Razor. President Lysars to the door, please. President Lysars, Paul Cambria, and Razor.
Okay.
Coming to the door. What else you got here?
How about Blue Skies? Flip ahead a couple of pages here.
Blue Skies.
Blue Skies. But I want to, there's a lot of good tunes.
He brought
here.
This stuff that's like $1,000 a shot. What a show off. Paul Cambria, Louis the 13th. That's what he said he was bringing. It's the stuff they always show off in the bar. And they,
oh, really?
Paul's the only guy that buys it. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, for your entertainment, we've got Paul and Razor tonight. It's Razor, and he brought his friend Paul and Louie. He brought Louie. I wish he brought some snow tires instead. Something I could use. That's the studded snow tire of whiskey, ladies and gentlemen, of bourbon. He brought his bowling bag.
Oh, great.
Blue skies. You don't let chaos stand in the way. We don't let chaos stand in the way of show business. Smiling at Susan, nothing but blue skies.
Blue skies, smiling at me, nothing but blue skies. Do I see bluebird?
Now we'll do it sultry.
Okay. Blue sky.
Blue sky.
really slow.
It's like a storm moving in, but you know it's coming, so you better know.
How about like this?
Blue sky, smiling at me. Oh, nothing but blue sky.
$10,000 worth of bourbon over there. They ran out of glasses just before they got to me. Well, yeah, I don't want to. I usually drink Louis the 13th from the bottle, but I'll use it. I've never had it. I don't think I've ever had it. Very exciting, David Vernon. We're about to drink some. One of the guests brought Louis the 13th. Took this huge red box. Look at that. It's beautiful. It's got like mirrors in there and stuff. Stick around, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, I know. Bring me one, would you? Look at these guys, their toes, they didn't even bring me one. Well, where's mine? What the hell? I get the empty box. I got the empty box. Paul's bringing me my 13th. Bucky 13. I usually drink Zippo the 13th. Wow, this is exciting. Happy New Year, Paul.
Listen, your buddy Croce
yes.
getting 150 shots.
I know, well, that's crazy. He charged 150 for everything. You park.
Yeah, to park.
You don't pay for parking. They walk you out of your car for 150
double
bucks.
Booted. So, double booted. Oh, good, Mary.
That smells wonderful. What do you think, Razor? What do you think?
Better than sex with my ex-wife. Why? I have three ex-wives. I treated them every 5 years. I'd like to do my spell.
Well, yeah, I can. Who doesn't? Here he comes. Just 5 seconds too late for Louis the 13th.
Party can start.
Dave's here and Jane's here. And this is, well, I guess we made it to 2019, for crying out loud. Yeah, that box is a masterpiece. I'd like to keep my bowling shoes in that, David Vernon.
Well, you have to tell us how this is good for your vocal cords.
Yeah, really. I mean, it's high calorie.
It is. Jane, Happy New Year. Man, this stuff is
flavorful, isn't it? No. The sprinkler system's going to go off. Paul, leave the empty bottle here, and I'll refill it with some of my $5 stuff, and my friends won't know the difference. Come fly with me. Susan's gonna fly away. Susan forgot all about singing when she got that Louis the 13th. I'm going to put her charts off to the side here. Well, because Paul walked in with that super fancy stuff. Camille's here, ladies and gentlemen. Happy New Year, Camille. Wonderful to see you. Happy 2019. You got here just in time. We're lounging it up. Now we're lounging it up with Camille, which is even better.
Hey, what do you have a cigar night, Howard? We have to have a cigar night.
Well, we can do that.
Oh, okay.
I love cigars. Don't smoke as many as I used to. Don't do a lot of things as much as I used to. I do lounge as much as I used to. Hey there, you with the stars in your eyes. Love never made a fool of you. You used to be too wise. Hey there, you with that high flying cloud. She won't throw a crumb to you. You think someday will come to you. Better forget her. She has you dancing on a string. Break it and she won't care. Won't you take this advice I hand you like a brother? Or are you not seeing things too clear? Too much in love to hear. All going in one ear and out the other. Hey there, you with the high flying cloud. I won't throw a crumb to you. I think someday I'll come to you. You better forget her. We're with her nose in the air. She has you dancing on a string. Break it and she won't care. Won't you take this advice I hand you like a brother? Not thinking things too clear. Too much in love to hear, all going in one ear and out the other.
Oh no, we have the verse to this.
Thank you, Jane. David Vernon is requesting that Susan sings another number. Susan Peters is getting her game face on, and she's gonna surprise me with a song that she's all excited about. I hope I know it. These are the things that we think about in show business. Fly me
in C. Is that in C?
Yeah.
This is my original tune.
We're gonna go
Flying with Susan Peters. What a wonderful moment this has.
Yeah,
are
you having fun? That was just a good
stuff. Isn't that something? That costs as much, a shot of that, I'm told, costs as much as one of Mark Croce's parking tickets.
Oh, yeah, that'd be a lot.
How do you like it, this one, Susan?
Not too slow, not too fast. Kind of half fast.
Okay, start it off and I'll come in.
No.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Can you give me the last eight?
Last eight?
And let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and above. The words hold my head. In other words, darling, just speak. Fill my heart with song and let me see forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you.
We saw a Chinese craft up there when we were there, right?
It was a meteorite.
I heard they're on the dark side. Oren loved it. So did I, Oren. Nice to see you, Lynn Averill. Happy New Year once more. Susan Peter. Is that Lounge Academy? Night at Lounge Academy, Jane.
Well, nobody said
sit down and keep me company. Everybody's enjoying the vibe. What was that, Jane?
I was at
a swell house party, and I felt fine. I was wide awake.
Excellent.
Was not fighting, you know, sleepiness in any way.
And you don't want to waste the next day.
I was completely sober. I didn't drink till I got home. Came home, it's like New Year's Eve. I gotta have a shot.
There you go.
Wish I had a shot of this Louis the 13th when I was. Nice of Paul.
I'll try to do a request that you will know. You know everything, but.
Jane, today I may not have a thing at all. Except for just a dream and a shot of 13. I've got lots of plans for tomorrow, and all my tomorrows be warm and Jane. Right now it may not seem like spring at all. We're drifting and the laughs are few. I've got rainbows planned for tomorrow. All my tomorrows belong to you. No one knows better than I that love keeps passing me by. That's fate. But with you there by my side, I'll soon be turning the tide. Just wait for me. I've got arms that cling at all. It's you that I'll be clinging to. All the dreams I dream, beg, and borrow on some tomorrow, they all come true. And all my bright tomorrows belong to you. All my tomorrows. Sure. Yeah, let's give that a try.
It looks hard.
Because they are.
I think I've seen more complicated, though, but...
I ruin them easy or difficult. I
know. If you were just, like, if you were just looking up a book of English words, the way you read it, is that how you could read music?
Well, yeah, the way I read English is about the way I read music, too. Dyslexia.
No, but if you picked up something, you know,
I wish I had an excuse like dyslexia. Illiteracy, I think they call it. Okay, we're going to try this one. I like the way it has wine on it. Happy New Year, Dave.
Happy New Year.
How are you? Nice to see you.
Donuts and music. If I have to choose between the two, don't make me choose.
It's tough.
He says that about me, coffee and
bacon. Dave, don't throw. Don't throw donuts at me. Don't please my folks too much. Don't laugh my jokes too much. bouncy show thing they do. How would Guy do this one and go?
I don't know. I think you can put your own spin on it.
Something like this. Don't throw bouquets at me. Don't please my folks too much. Don't laugh at my jokes too much. People will say we're in love. Don't sigh and gaze at me. People will say we're in love. Don't start tapping glasses with flags. Give me roads and my club. Sweetheart, my perfect things. People will say. John Curry on the glass. That was nice. Now step away from the piece of wood.
Thank you for taking that request.
Oh, well, thank you. That was it's a great song. I wish I could do a better job with it. But,
may I take that?
But it's still a great song. This one is, yeah,
right.
It is. This is my favorite book. And since I've got my favorite cadets here tonight,
I'm going to put
the toys away.
We'll take,
stick around. We got a lot of entertainment.
Flip the page and see what we could do.
All right. Just as I was saying, that we Bewitched.
Don't do that, girl. Do not.
I figured you knew it.
Sorry.
Sing it, Howard.
Susan's wild again.
Uh-oh.
Beguiled again. You don't do that one?
No.
Let's find some other ones then. I just assumed you knew that one. I thought you did. Blue Room? You don't do Blue Room. No one does Blue Room. It's good to have animated people here tonight. Close enough for John Curry. Come fly with me. Did we do that one?
No, you did that one.
Oh, I did that one. I'm told. Crazy, he calls me. They say I'll move the mountains and I'll move the mountains if she wants them out of the way. Crazy, she calls me. Sure, I'm crazy. Crazy in love, I'd say. Say I go through fire, and I'll go through fire as she wants it, so shall it be.
Crazy she calls me. Sure I'm crazy. Crazy in love, you see. Like the wind that shakes the bough, she moves me with her smile. The difficult I'll do right now. The impossible will take a little while. Say I care forever, and I mean forever. If I have to hold up the sky, crazy she calls me. Sure, I'm crazy, crazy in love, am I? You're watching Lounge Academy on WBIG.Tv.
Susan has a song she'd like to sing. I think it's called Rain or Come Shine.
Yeah.
Yeah, then I'm really screwed.
Without of the money,
day may be cloudy or sunny. We're in or we're one of those things.
Stick around, everybody. We got a lot of talent in the audience tonight. We're going to be hearing some piano from Barry soon. I'll do a couple numbers and then we'll... The night is like a lovely tune. Beware my foolish heart. How wise the ever constant moon. Take care my foolish heart. There's a line between love and fascination. Hard to see on an evening such as this, but they both have the very same sensation. The moment of a kiss, your lips are much too close to mine. Take care, my foolish heart. Fascination, or the dream that will fade and fall apart. It's love. This time it's love, my foolish heart. Foolish heart. Thank you, Paul and Richard. Thank you for watching Lounge Academy. Every Friday night, live on my Facebook profile. Oh. Yeah, it fixes anything. Just reboot everything, I don't know.
Look on YouTube, they'll tell you how to fix it.
They told me I spoiled it on the software end and
could be a 4:30 assembly. Stick around, we got Barry coming up very soon. I can't give you anything but love, baby. That's the only thing I've plenty of, my baby. Rimawa, schemawa, we're sure to find happiness, and I'll guess all those things you've always pined for achieving. I'd like to see you looking swell, my baby. Diamond bracelets, Woolworth doesn't sell, my baby. Till that lucky day, you know darn well. Well, 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 baby. I can't give you anything but love. Bracelets, Woolworth doesn't sell, my baby. Till that lucky day, you know darn well. Well, well, baby, I can't give you anything but love, baby. I can't give you anything but love at Lounge Academy. Cy Coleman. I'm sentimental, so I walk in the rain. I've got some habits even I can't explain. Could start for the corner, burn up in Spain. Why try to change me now? I'll sit and daydream. I've got daydreams galore. Cigarette ashes, there they go on the floor. I'll go away weekends, leave my keys in the door. Why try to change me now? Why can't I be more conventional? People talk, people stare, so I try. That's not for me, 'cause I can't see my kind of crazy world go passing me by. So let people wonder if a circus hit town. You know I love you till the moon's upside down. Don't you remember I was always your clown? Why try to change me? Why? why try to change me now? Red Lounge Academy. I hope you feel better, Bill Jenkins. Later, hanging out and lounging with us.
Come on, bye bye, Blake.
I need something.
Okay, let's find your chair.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's great having Susan Peters on the bandstand. They're at Lounge Academy. All your favorite Lounge Cadets are here, ladies and gentlemen, at home. Nice to see a woman who knows her way around a fake book.
That's right, baby.
One of these days she's going to walk in here with Hal Leonard. Where is it? I don't see it. You see that painting? Isn't it amazing? There's a great song that everybody thinks of Susan Peters when they hear this performing because she has a patent on it.
Pack up all my cares and clothes. Here I go, saying hello. Bye, bye. Sugar sweet and so sweet. Bye, 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 blackbird. No one here can love or understand me. Oh, what hard luck stories they all can be. Make my bed and light a light. I'll cry late tonight. Black pearl, bye bye. Sweet and so is she. Well,
ba 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 blah. Well, no one here can love or understand me. All those outlaw stories, they all hang with me. Oh, baby, make my bed and light the light. I'll arrive late tonight. Blackbird, oh my blackbird, oh my blackbird, bye-bye. Adios, pájaro negro.
Great, Susan.
I like that.
I hope Alex Leonard was paying attention to that one.
Alex?
Susan Peters, Alex.
Leonard Feather? Did you say Leonard Feather was here?
Alex Leonard.
He might be. His daddy might be here. You never know. Sometimes deaf people come. Here it is.
Well, especially in an old house, right?
There you go. In an old house, for sure.
Okay. I'm going to put everything into this one.
Oh, whoa. All
right. Because it's called All of Me.
Okay.
As it should be.
Give me some half and half.
Three quarters and three quarters.
All of me, why not take all of me? Can't you see I'm no good without you? Take my eyes, I'll never use them. Take my lips, I love to lose them. Your goodbye has left me with eyes that cry. How can I go on, dear, without you? You took the part that once was mine. Why not take all of me? Now we get a little body. Oh, both of me, why not take both of me? Can't you see I'm no good without you? Take this side, I'll never use it. Or you can take this side, I'll just abuse it. Your goodbye has left me with eyes that cry. How can I get by without you? You took the part that once was my heart. Why not take all of me? Why not take all of me? It's a package deal, baby. That's it. Thank you so much, Howard. Oh. WBIG.TV.
I don't use that bell very often. Richie's been waiting 40 years. He hasn't heard me use that bell. I heard it now. Maybe we could get, if we coax him a little bit. He's not exhausted from that painting he's been working on. Maybe we can get him to come up here and play some of his set. Barry, how about it? You gotta let's try to give Barry a little encouragement. We can get him to come up and play some piano. How about it, Barry? He does everything. He does paints the pictures, he plays the pictures. Yeah. Probably is the hernia surgeon.
I know about it. I know about it, Holly.
Hernia surgeon.
Yeah.
Gastroenterology.
Is that all she does?
I don't know. She did me.
Oh. That's enough, I guess, right?
Yeah.
Maybe she does other things.
Well, we won't get personal about
her. Yeah, I know. That's a good idea.
Yeah.
That's a real old.
Yeah, it is.
Try to understand. never stop loving.
Thank you.
No, it just repeats itself.
Yeah,
then at the end she goes,
"My lady,
cheek to cheek." When it began,
oh, yeah.
Boston and all this stuff. won that pony. That was very good. I only had like a little table.
That was very good.
Thank you,
sir.
Paul Cambry.
Yeah,
very nice. Yeah. Yeah. I guess I don't know him well. I
don't
really know him. Louis is a wrestler. I always wanted to be at the piano, so I. Yeah. It was nice that you sat at the piano too. We're supposed to be at the piano.
Oh, for video?
That's right.
Who's up now?
I don't know. I think Howard should come back. Yeah.
Yeah. peanuts turned over there. So I was like,
tonight of first. First time we have Louis the 13th. Lounge Academy. This is the end of the show. We refer to it as the epilogue. An up tune. Then she'll sing a ballad. When she's done, she'll sit down with the folks and eat a bowl of salad. She's Susan Peter. You gotta meet her at Lounge Academy. Live on Friday. I woke up this morning. I went to Lounge Academy. I woke up this morning, went to Lounge Academy. Richie was there, bowling harp for me. Tell me about Richie. Thank you.
put another one in there. I put the E flat in there.
We got a real blues crowd here tonight.
It could have been a minor if I put an E flat in there, right?
Is that kind of a downer?
You're just too good to be true. Oops. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I want to hold you so much. And I feel long last love has arrived. And I thank God I'm alive. You're much too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. Pardon the way that I stare. There's nothing else to compare. You'd be like something to something. Much too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you.
Something a little different. I didn't know you guys were such rock and rollers. We're rocking all night long and partying all day. Sleep all day. Wild Horses. Oh, yeah, that's, Angie was nice, too. I'll learn them. I'm going to learn some rock tunes. Yeah, but it's from the, yeah. Well, yeah, don't worry. Besides, what, a piano isn't a rock band, you know, so you're better off doing Angie.
Are you thinking of Freddie Mercury? He was definitely rock and he was piano.
Yeah, he was Freddie Mercury.
Are
you
comparing yourself to Freddie?
No.
No, I'm just saying.
He was arguably the best.
Have you seen the movie?
No. I don't have to. I already know all about Freddie Mercury. I love Freddie Mercury.
Yeah. Did you see the movie? I heard it was good.
I heard it's great. But
I'll see it again.
Maybe I'll see it.
Okay, well, I'll go.
I got nothing against it.
No, I wanted to see it.
Tommaso's out there. Hey, Tommaso. We love you, Tommaso. Happy New Year. Tommaso Sausage, Tommaso. Sponsor of WBIG.TV.
Thank you,
Tommaso. Hey, Tommaso.
Tommaso Sausage is amazing.
You might see Mary over by your, if you're over by 42 Court Street, 42 Delaware, you're going to see Mary because she's going to be on the park bench there.
I'm going to be right on the park bench by Tommaso Sausage.
Yeah, she's doing a commission to sketch one of the buildings on your corner.
Yeah, so I'm going to be there sitting on that
So
bench.
If you're there, I think you, Tommaso, are you still there at 2 o'clock to pick up your trailer? Let me know what your hours are over there, Tommaso. I'll go over to see Mary and I'll come and see you. Thank everybody for joining us tonight at Lounge Academy. It's been another great Friday in the can here, so to speak. We had some great surprise guests. They're all a surprise to me. So So from all the cadets here to all the cadets out there, we wish you a great week.
The fact that the city gets more money in the parking meter should go an extra hour.
Well,
if
you get out there and do it, I think that you'll find
because you got to be free by 10.
You know, if you enjoy something, people start coming at 10, you get better at it.
You go an extra hour, you'd be going to 11:30.
So much fun with it, and I feel so.
That doesn't make sense.
Well, yeah, makes sense.
Look how dead it is. People don't want to come down and put money in the meters.
Yeah, they're probably burned out anyway.
Find another place to go.
Yeah. Well, I think they're deciding not to do that. Sounds like, yeah.
Mohawk and Elmwood, they got the sign off already. Did you change it?
Yeah, I think there was enough of an uprising to where...
Don't do that. I hope it does make them change.
I think they're going to probably double the rates like they did, but they'll just be the old hours. Yeah. Yeah, I know. They
for my hour from 9 to 10. I got here about 9, yeah.
When are you going back? Tomorrow?
I'm going to go back, I think, tomorrow.
Bye, Howard. Thank you very much.
What a thing.
Thank you, David. Thanks for coming out.
Are we on we're going to have you and Mary over to the house and see her art farm.
Oh, see her lights.
Yeah, because you have to, in your piano, you have to plan our piano.
Again, not
party.
Too.
Yeah,
like a grain.
Yeah.
Like a
concert D or something. No, I mean, you've got a piano, right?
Because I'm like,
oh,
I
yeah.
would
oh, I thought
totally
you had
get that.
Yeah.
And I'm like,
work like that. I love it.
Oh,
well,
yeah. Well,
I go sketching.
There's people that do that. What?
Well,
you got to do
well,
is. I have friends that have oboes. They bring their oboe.
Yeah.
This is nothing except.
Yeah,
the
oboe is
I'll let you know what time I'm going.
If you play it well, it's
one of
the most beautiful sounds.
Well, and I would say,
can't
I got a client.
Yeah,
this is
what
I
do.
Yes.
It always sounds like.
I got to go around the oboe wavelength.
Exactly.
Okay, well, thanks, everybody. I'm going to let you go for the evening, and we'll see you again next Friday around 7 o'clock on WBIG-TV, right on my Facebook profile. And if you miss us before that, you could tune in to Donut Tuesdays are resuming the regular schedule January 8th, which is this Tuesday. So we'll be turning those cameras on at around 11:30. Our hours are 11:30 to 1:30. We're open 2 hours every Tuesday out in the, we have a booth out in front of the old house downtown. It's called the City of Buffalo Department of Coffee and Donuts. And my wife, Mary, and I sell donuts to people on the sidewalk. And the beautiful thing is we televise it and we get to find out what's going on. Because the man on the street walking on the sidewalk down here by Niagara Square, they're the ones, you know, that know what's going on. So they're very nice people. And all right, well, so we're going to let you guys go. We'll see you Tuesday at Donut Tuesday TV, and especially next Friday here at Lounge Academy, where we'll do it all over again. Let me use my powerful finger to press the button, and we'll be in the ether until next week. Good night, everybody, and thank you. We had a great time tonight. Happy New Year once more.